Welcome to the Wednesday, May 8th, 2013 edition of Erner Berry's Daily Video, sponsored by Moark Eggs. In today's video, declines in a top importing market impact U.S. turkey exports. And later, replacement costs for frozen U.S. pangasius imports reach a five-year low. Now let's look at the markets with your host, Jamie Chadwick.
The National Restaurant Association Senior Vice President of Research and Knowledge testified to a U.S. House subcommittee on the benefits that travel and tourism have on the U.S. restaurant industry, which is leading job creation, particularly during peak traveling months in the summer. In a typical summer season, restaurants will add more than 400,000 jobs, and that figure trails only the construction industry. The testimony follows a rough first quarter for the U.S. restaurant industry that saw traffic and sales figures down due to an increase in the payroll tax and poor winter weather. However, the latest restaurant performance index did indicate a slight increase in same-store sales in March, though traffic continued to be an issue. To boost U.S. restaurant business, the NRA encouraged lawmakers to embrace policies that promote stronger travel and tourism, including reducing barriers to international travel, stepping up promotion of the U.S. as an international destination, and increasing business meal deductibility. For more on the testimony to the House subcommittee and for other Center of the Plate protein news, head over to foodmarket.com. In other news, a decline in U.S. turkey exports to Mexico was noted in March. Here is Erner Berry poultry market reporter James Serpico with the latest.
It probably isn't any great shocker to those following the export markets that for the third month in a row, year-on-year turkey shipments to Mexico are down. This has been enough to lower year-to-date worldwide exports for 1.5%. March exports totaled 27.8 thousand tons and were valued slightly over $51 million, down more than 5% and 11% from the same month last year, respectively. The trade data shows that this decline was due largely to decreased shipments to Mexico, Hong Kong, and the Philippines. Meanwhile, cumulative turkey exports in the first quarter of 2013 were down a little more than 1.5% in volume and more than 5% in value. The most significant departure from the trend established last year was with Mexico, where exports diminished by 13.5% year over year. China increased by 123% to over 14,000 tons. Exports to Canada were up 3% from the same period of 2012, but exports to the Philippines were down significantly by 44%. Although relatively small in comparison, the role Angola is playing in advancing U.S. turkey exports is unmistakable, rising by 262% during the first quarter. Attractive parts prices are at the root of South Africa's heightened export presence. For a complete look at this week's turkey letter, be sure to head over to Comtel and click Library under the Poultry tab.
Thanks, James. To wrap up today's video, overseas replacement costs for frozen U.S. pangasius fillets are at their lowest levels in years. Here's Seafood.com News staff writer Michael Ramsing with the report.
The import value per pound for U.S. frozen pangasius fillet imports has reached its lowest level in years, benefiting from record U.S. import levels, along with a decrease in European imports at the end of 2012. The overseas replacement cost is calculated by dividing the U.S. Department of Commerce's total value of pangasius frozen fillets by total pounds. According to the most recent calculation, the current replacement cost for U.S. frozen pangasius fillets is $1.33 per pound, the lowest figure since January 2008, when the price is $1.32 per pound. The decline began in March 2012, following a record year for U.S. pangasius imports that saw 2011 level totals reach 194 million pounds. The trend continued through 2012, which saw another record-breaking year for U.S. pangasius imports that totaled 213.8 million pounds. The increase in available product for U.S. importers was also aided by declines in EU demand, the largest market for Vietnamese pangasius. According to Eurostat, European pangasius imports fell 22% in 2012 from 403.6 million pounds to 314 million pounds, a difference of about 90 million pounds. This increase in available inventory for U.S. importers not only contributed to a decline in replacement costs, but contributed to near record low prices in the market. Currently, the Erner Berry price for 3 to 5 ounce frozen pangasius fillets from Vietnam has remained steady at $1.80 per pound since mid-March. In fact, were it not for a recent duty rate increase that saw an overnight 35-cent per pound tariff increase on Pangasius imports, prices had held steady at $1.70 per pound since December, the lowest quoted price for the item since June of 2010. So, despite a recent uptick in the Pangasius market due to recent duty rate hikes, global inventories remain reportedly strong and have contributed to a 5-year low in overseas replacement costs for U.S. importers. For a complete look at Pangasius and other aquaculture markets in the U.S., be sure to check out the May 2013 Aquaculture Insiders Report due out this week under the World Trade section in the Seafood tab on Comtel.
Thanks, Michael. That concludes today's video. Thanks for watching and have a great day.
This broadcast is sponsored by Moark Eggs. For more than 50 years, Moark has grown their business with a commitment to adding real value to their products and services, providing old-fashioned customer service that is tested and proven to meet your needs. Visit them online at www.moarkllc.com or give them a call at 866-757-EGGS.